Hey guys, what's up? Shadowlands back with another update video. I know it's not a live one this time, guys. I was really not feeling too good about recording with my iPad tonight, so I just wanted to go ahead and record this, so I just wanted to get this out for now. So I just wanted to go over a bunch of stuff today about where we're going to be heading as far as my YouTube channel and even some stuff with Combat Arms. I have a lot of stuff, but it's all pertaining to what's going to be happening from now until about October, maybe November, sometime in then. And definitely some stuff for over this summer. So I don't have this, you know, commentary practiced, obviously. It's entirely live, just doing it once. Don't want to re-record it, so just want to go ahead and get a lot of this stuff out. I'm going to be going through this stuff fairly quickly, so if you have questions about anything, please post in the comment section below, and we'll see where we go from there. So starting off, as of episode 53, I am starting season 3 of my top 5 videos of the week series. I will be accepting videos for all games as of that episode. Up until now, that one guy that keeps sending in a COD video every week, I've just been immediately shutting that down because I'm not taking that kind of video right now. But as of episode 53, I encourage all of you to be sending in your videos from all types of games, and I understand that right off the bat, there's not going to be a lot of stuff outside of Combat Arms. We might have one or two videos a week that are not Combat Arms. But over time, I do plan to kind of, you know, expand that and encourage other YouTubers to be sending in their materials. So if you have like a favorite YouTuber out somewhere, tell them that if they send in their videos to my channel, they may get, you know, shouted out and stuff. And that's definitely a way to get that done. So good way to get some more people, you know, shown there for other games, because I realize Combat Arms is not the only game in the world, and that my channel is not called like Shadowlands CA or something. This is my channel for any kind of game. So that's that. That being said, I am going to be expanding to more games soon. You'll be seeing more types of gameplay, going over different commentary. Now, the commentary has to do with Combat Arms. I'm going to put it over Combat Arms gameplay and stuff. I'm not going to put Combat Arms commentary over Soldier Front 2 or something. I'm not stupid. Despite what many of you guys may think, I am incredibly stupid sometimes. I say stupid stuff, I do stupid stuff, but I'm not stupid. So without that stuff, I'm going to just put that out there. But I will have a lot more games doing that, so I will get into that very soon. Also, as of October, I am getting transferred to a different college. I am going to Oregon State University for some research, so that's going to be really, really cool. It has to do with my lab group and stuff that I've been talking with you guys over the past, you know, few months or so. So any of you guys who are aware of that, I will be moving. That being said, I've been talking with my new roommate for next year, and he's super interested in co-hosting some series with me, so that's going to be a thing. If I do other games like Minecraft HD or something, if I bring that back around that time, he may be co-hosting with me. Chris won't be going with me, unfortunately, so we won't be able to do as many episodes with him, although he may be able to hop on for a few during Skype. So if you guys liked Chris, I'm very, very sorry, but he's not going to be going with me to Oregon State, unfortunately, so it'll be harder for me to do videos with him, although I do definitely hope to get him on Skype sometime to continue doing some commentaries with me. He's still one of my best friends, and I do want to get him involved if I can. Next up, as of October, I'm going to be doing fewer Combat Arms videos because of these other videos I plan on doing, and I need suggestions for games to play. They don't have to be free to play. I'm currently leaning towards Soldier Front 2, Counter-Strike Global Offensive, DayZ Standalone specifically, Titanfall, and Minecraft. And if I do Titanfall, I'm going to be recording it through my Xbox. I do have access to an Xbox One and a recorder for it, so I will hopefully be able to do that. And then, like I said before, Minecraft. And if I do Minecraft, it's going to be a multiple person. It's going to be a guest commentary type thing where I have other people in with me. Probably my roommate if he plays Minecraft, and a bunch of other people as well. I probably want to try to get, you know, 4 to 6 people in that with me. Now, over the summer, I've said this a couple of times already, I'm going to be making a massive tactics video run. I want to cover every map in the game, and sometimes more than once for different types of strategies and different tactics, but I want to cover every map in Combat Arms for tactics videos over the summer. So expect a lot of those, like maybe 2 to 3 a week. There are a lot of videos to cover in not that many weeks. I believe I have about 15 weeks of summer. I have a very long summer this year, but that's way more than there are maps. I believe there's about 45 maps in Combat Arms, maybe even more than that, and I've only done about 10 of them. So, I mean, at least really in-depth, and there are some that I'll be redoing from before. If I were to really count them all up, I've probably done about 20 of them, but I'm going to be redoing a lot of them. So that's about 30 maps that I still have left to cover, some of them more than once. So I'm expecting 2 to 3 tactics videos a week, so expect a lot of those. That being said, I have too many series running right now, and I know in my previous update video, I told you Theory of Everything would be coming back at some point. But now that I have too many series running, and the fact that the series was never very successful in the first place, makes me very, very hesitant to bring it back. So it's probably not going to be coming back this summer, if ever at all. It's a very in-depth series. It requires more work than any of the other videos I have to put in, because I have to make the whole write-up, get good pictures of it, and then post it and do the commentary around that. It's one of those commentaries that I usually have to record or re-record several times because I say something I don't mean to, and it's too hard to cut that out. So, Theory of Everything may or may not be coming back. It's a lot of work for not very much yield. I may do an episode here or there just to see what happens, and if for some reason it's wildly successful, I may bring it back, but I don't think that's going to happen. I will experiment with that a bit, and maybe the next month or so. I haven't decided yet. Next up, just something to kind of break the tension here. I know it's so far been fairly serious stuff. I just wanted to let you guys know about another really funny pet peeve that I've got. A lot of people will threaten to DDoS you or to ping attack you, but it really pisses me off when they say DDoS, and specifically DDoS. They don't understand what they're saying. DDoS means distributed denial of service attack, and what that means is they have hundreds, definitely more than just a couple of computers attacking one person. And I guarantee you, nobody on Combat Arms, at least no one that would bother, no smart person, no one smart enough to do this, would actually DDoS you. If there are, then they obviously hate you a lot more than is worth their time or yours. What they are doing is they are DOSing you with one computer. They are not DDoSing you. So if they say that, if someone says they're DDoSing you, you can assume they're already dumb enough that they don't know what the hell they're doing. So if someone threatens to DDoS you, feel free to laugh it off and just realize that you are talking to a complete fucking retard. Next up, and back to more serious topics, Tears of Fear is recruiting again. A few days ago, we did have a really big problem where a lot of our members got kicked. We were immediately able to get a bunch of them back in, so that was very, very quickly remedied. But that being said, we are down by about 20 members from where we were before. Granted, it's sort of a two-way street. It's also sort of a blessing because it removed all of our inactive players. That being said, we have quite a few spots open now, and we are definitely recruiting, so I wanted to remind you guys that. The four requirements that we're generally looking for, these could be give or take a bit because I realize some of these aren't as, you know, accurate as we'd like them to be. We're looking in general for a 1.0 plus KDR. Now, we're not being super, super freaking strict on that, but we definitely want to see that you do have the skill to play with us, and we will definitely play a couple of games with you before we let you in. Next up, TeamSpeak 3 is a dead requirement. We will not let you in without TeamSpeak 3. We will require that you get onto TeamSpeak 3 before we even let you in the clan. So that's just to get you to talk to us, say hi to us, get to play a game with us or two, and see that you at least have it. Because a lot of people say, oh, I'll get it later, and then they never do. So we're not falling for that again. Sorry, guys. Gotta have TeamSpeak 3. On top of that, it shouldn't be that big of a deal, because it makes the clan a lot more fun to be in. That's true of any clan, any game even. Next up is Second Lieutenant Plus. We're just very, very generally looking for Second Lieutenant Plus. A lot of players that we've had apply are around Major or LTC or even higher than that. But for the few of you that are a little bit below that, we're not going to say no because you're a CSM4 or something if you have the skills and you meet all the other requirements. The last two is that we obviously require a fairly high level of activity. We're not going back to the same problem we had before. So that's really kind of a big point there. And the last thing is maturity. Now, this will usually speak for itself in the end. I would rather take a quiet, very respectful, mature 12-year-old than I would take a loud, obnoxious, kind of arrogant 18-year-old. So being completely honest, I require a nice amount of maturity. And that is hard to come by these days, but, you know, it's a thing, and I'm definitely going to be, you know, upholding that. Next up for me, this summer is going to either be extremely disappointing or extremely successful for Nexon. Sorry, this wasn't really for me, this is more for Nexon. The turnout of this summer with Combat Arms is going to determine where it goes for the rest of its life. This is a pivotal time, and I guarantee you Nexon knows this. The reason being is because this is the last summer that they're going to have the largest number of players on. Next time, next year at this time, they are not going to have anywhere near the number of people they're going to have on this summer. This is really their last chance to really get a bunch of people online at once, impress their players, and get people into the game. So either we're going to see, we're probably going to see a lot of stuff this summer. And if it's disappointing, then chances are Nexon is digging its own grave for Combat Arms, and it's going to get exponentially worse after the summer is over. So at the end of the summer, it's really going to determine where we are. And that's part of the reason I said before, in October, I'm going to be moving on to other games as well. I've been sitting here on Combat Arms for a long time. And while I'm absolutely still going to be doing videos on it, probably still about half of my videos or more are going to be Combat Arms. not all of them are going to be combat arms anymore, so that's part of that as well. On the other hand, if it goes very, very well, this could be the one chance Nexon has to really fix combat arms, so I have a lot of expectations of them. I just really hope they can fill those shoes. Next I wanted to mention is something I mentioned earlier, actually. MCHG is officially going on hiatus, at least until October. I know I haven't done a video in a while, and it's sort of been on hiatus for a while, but now I'm just officially saying it's on hiatus until October at the earliest. I will reevaluate it then and see who's interested in doing that series with me, because I definitely don't want to do it alone. Continuing, I want to put a website in the description of this video. Go check this out. If you're into metal, dubstep, or any of these kind of electronic or really hardcore music styles, go check out this website. It is a place to get free music from indie bands, and I'm going to type in the name of a artist below that called Muryoku P. If you're interested in really, really heavy metal that also is kind of like piano as well, it covers a bunch of stuff, it's a really good band, they're really good. They do have, about half of their albums are Japanese, but the other half are just instrumental, and it's really good. I actually don't care for their Japanese ones as much, but they are really, really good, and this is just a great site for a bunch of stuff. They have hundreds of albums and artists, so if you're just looking for free music, great place to do it. Next up, I am still looking for a few more intros to be made, about 4 or 5 of them, and I want them to be modeled after the ones made for me by OinkCA. I will provide the character images. They're basically the ones I'm using now, how I have like 3 or 4 different ones that I use, so I kind of want a few more of those modeled off of that. So just if you're interested in making intros for me, it is definitely worth a shout out, just like I did for OinkCA, but that's just what I'm looking for. And finally, I've been playing a lot of single player games recently to take a break from Combat Arms. But as I start to beat them, I'm sort of winding down and moving back into Combat Arms for the summer. I've been playing about 10 different single player games all at once, and over the past month or so, I've been absolutely beating the crap out of them, and I really haven't been playing much Combat Arms in lieu of that, but I'm sort of winding down on that. I'm down to my last like 3 to 4 games that I'm playing. I'm expecting to beat them over the next 2 to 3 weeks, hopefully, and around that time, I should be getting into summer then. Finals will be over. I actually have 2 finals this semester that I'm worrying about, or technically this quarter, so there's that, and then I will be pretty much almost entirely on Combat Arms. I am planning on doing a really hardcore workout regimen this summer. During the year, I normally run an all-year P90X style workout that I do, and then during the summer, I usually make it a P180. No, I don't do a P180X, I just do a P180. So I'm going to be doing that, and that's going to be my big project for the summer for myself, since I actually, for the first time in years, have the entire summer to do nothing. So I'm going to be doing that, and I'm going to be doing a lot of Combat Arms and YouTube, so I hope to see a lot of you guys on over the summer. And that's about going to conclude my moving forward update video. Thank you guys for watching if you are still watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Shadowlance out.